Hey everybody, welcome, and thanks for joining us today on this edition of Tips from TTO, presented by The Rep. A lot of stuff going on, right, Meg?
Yes, lots.
We hope you're enjoying Tips from TTO, and today, I know this might seem a little strange that you see us sitting next to each other, but you know, we decided to jump in it
and go for it.
That's right,
because we know we're safe.
We are safe, and we are trying for a little normalcy today. So if you're following TTO on their Facebook and LinkedIn, Megan's
yes.
LinkedIn, like the page, we appreciate that. If you haven't, please do so. Click that like button, click the follow button, please.
The lots rep, of info R-A-P, out there.
Lots of info. Follow us. We appreciate it. You can find them on Facebook at the tax office. We want to say hello to Megan today from the tax office.
Yes.
Micro business specialist in accounting payroll. Working with the tax office because they are more
than a tax office.
There you go. Look at that.
That we are, especially right now.
So there's a lot of stuff happening in the world today.
Yes.
And we don't want to lessen anything, but you know, at some point we've got to get back to a little bit of normalcy. So today Megan and I chose to come to the studio and talk to you today about what's happening in the world, what's
yes.
happening in small business.
Yes.
Some information that can help you. I know they've spent some time over at the tax office going through a bunch of stuff, yeah?
Yeah, definitely fielding phone calls and creating resources and getting those resources out there for all of our small business, our sister companies out there kind of struggling with everything going on.
And that's what it is. And, you know, we discuss a lot of times about just the basic stuff about business and whatnot. But today we're facing a very political issue, are we not?
Yes, it is a situation. We don't want to lessen that. It is a situation and it is serious, but there are resources out there and there is light at the end of the tunnel. So no struggle.
That's what we hope for.
Yes.
You know, we want to present to you folks today the fact that, you know, although we understand Megan and I work closely together on a regular basis, we know each other. You know, if you don't know somebody, walking up and giving them big hugs, probably not the thing to do.
Probably not.
You know, washing your hands, keeping your distance.
Absolutely. And
like
yes,
that.
And that's how you continue to, you know, keep yourself out of harm's way.
But
not,
you know,
going overboard.
Here's the one thing, folks, and I want to make this, and I'm not putting light to anything, but I do that every flu season, and I don't get the flu. And the flu, we say get a flu shot. I don't know how many people I've met that got a flu shot that have the flu.
Every year.
Every
happens.
Year.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a vaccination that will stop something. And what they continue to talk about with a vaccine, and that we can't open the country till we get a vaccine and this and that, is really just silliness.
It is, because the vaccines change every year because the strands change every year. So keeping yourself safe, washing your hands, mm-hmm. not walking around sneezing on people, whatnot, that should be a normal thought process throughout the year. I mean, I know at the tax office, we practice that every day because we do come in contact with a
That's
lot of
right.
people.
That's right.
So
hygiene is good, period.
Right.
And,
showers.
You know, if you're having respiratory issues, because it is a respiratory virus.
It is. Mm-hmm.
With a 98% recovery rate, 98% recovery rate. We want to make sure that people are aware of that. And the country is recovering. And I think it's time that we focus on some positive things rather than listening
Absolutely.
To the media continue to tell people that the worst is still to come. We're going to shut down everything. There'll be nothing for 18 to 20 months, 12 to 18 months.
Yeah, that came out yesterday.
Right?
Yeah.
And think about our livelihood, our families, what we have, what we've been given, the freedoms and the rights that we have in this country because of what it is. And, you know, we sit here as business owners.
Absolutely. Micro business owners. Yes. So we're in the same boat.
And we are facing those things just like many of you out there are. And I think it's time for us to stand up, talk realistically about the reality of what we're dealing with. And I know there will be people that will not agree with me.
And not agree. Yes. Right. And
it is America.
It is. We still do have that right. Yes, absolutely. That's yes, fine. And we need to remember that.
It doesn't hurt my feelings. It really doesn't. I don't get mad about that stuff. If you have that opinion, that's fine. That doesn't mean we can't still have a conversation.
Absolutely. Right? Absolutely. I don't think the conversation should stop, because if it does, that's when fear comes into play.
That's right.
It does. And I think we need to distinguish the facts, because there are lots of facts out there. Yeah. And then there's some fear in the middle there. So which one, you know, I mean, I'm all about facts.
Right.
Black and
right.
white. This is what it is. And not letting that fear take over. Absolutely.
And, you know, Megan, that is that's the biggest thing. I think there are so many people out there who are scared and afraid of what's coming.
Yes. Yes.
And or the lack of knowing what's coming.
The lack of knowledge, because there is a lot of information out there with the political system and things changing on a day-to-day basis. Government buildings being shut down, not being able to get through. So yeah, there's a lot of gray areas right now. And so yeah, fear will take over. Being scared will take over, because what do you do?
Right.
And so that's right. What we're here to kind of lessen that and say, hey, here's the facts. This is what's going on.
You know, we both wash our hands. We make sure.
Absolutely.
I'm not gonna spit on Megan right. or anything like that. And I don't mean, I'm not trying to just be funny for the sake
right,
of being funny.
But I hope
funny,
he wouldn't spit
just,
on me regardless of what was going on.
Right. I wouldn't do it anyway. I mean, and that's the thing. Respect the people around you.
Absolutely.
Show some respect for people around you. There's nothing wrong with those things. But to shut down our entire country and our entire economy because of this, and I know people will think, oh, but the coronavirus, hey, listen, it's a 98% recovery recovery rate.
I don't even think the flu has that rate, does it?
When the Ebola outbreak came out, it's the Ebola has a, what is it, 50%?
That I think that might even
mortality
be
mortality rate.
Yes, it's pretty rough.
Mortality mm-hmm. rate. The flu this year, I'm sure they're saying, you know, because we curved it and whatnot, but there were less cases in California. We don't talk about these things because of the herd.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
The herd thought process.
Yes, like
because immunity, yes. mm-hmm. your body has a natural immune system that works. And I know people. No, I'm not an epidemiologist.
Right.
I'm not a doctor. I'm not but I can read.
Right.
I did go to. I even went to college.
Right.
And I have an education. I have. I study. I read. I pay attention. I think I have. Intelligence.
Intelligence, yes, to think
right?
outside
reason,
the box. Reason.
Reason,
yes.
Listening to people and listen. I've listened to both sides. I've heard what the other side has said as far as, you know, if we talk about the political part
of it. Yes. Mm-hmm.
I've
yes.
heard both sides. And the reasonable part of this, the intelligent part of this says that we can, as we've done for how many years, every time flu season comes,
practice great hygiene.
Practice the things that we normally do.
Right, absolutely.
And we will be okay. Mm-hmm. Are there going to be people that die from this? Yes.
Absolutely.
That's the reality. Mm-hmm. But there are people that die every day getting in their car going to work because of a car accident.
I used that analogy with a client the other day.
Right?
Yeah, that's the simplicity of it.
I mm-hmm. mean, and that's tragic. We're not going to stop people from driving.
No.
We'd like to.
Some people at least.
But here's the thing, guys. When are we going to not allow people to infringe on our rights as citizens, as small business
mm-hmm.
owners?
Absolutely.
And step out and begin to talk, write our congressmen, put ourselves in those places and say, have a voice within what's happening in this country. And quit allowing the government to dictate to us, the people who are supposed to be, I thought it said we the people,
we
yes?
We the people of the
we
United
the
States.
We the people, about dictating to us what is good for us and allowing us to be free and independent people to make our decisions and make them in a true democratic way.
Absolutely. I believe, I don't want to misspeak, but Sweden, I believe it was.
Yes.
Stepped up and said, yes, we understand that this is serious. We're not taking it lightly. However, we trust our citizens to do what's right, make right decisions, and have the knowledge and reason whether they need to stay at home or they need to go out. So, I mean, that's the simplicity of it. It's a virus. We understand that. We're not taking it lightly. But from a small business standpoint, from where we're sitting right now, there's a lot of facts out there. And we don't want to continue this type of thought process to... It's going to hinder people in the long run.
Yeah.
And we don't want to continue that.
No. I think the toughest thing is most people put it in a political situation, don't they?
Yes. And it this isn't political. I mean, it shouldn't be, at least.
It shouldn't be. I know. Well, you have the thing about it is, regardless of what we'd like, right?
Agreed. Yes.
There are political and economic ramifications no matter what.
Right. Well, when you shut down a nation, there are economic... Yes, it turns into that type of state. Yes,
and,
absolutely.
And we turn it into a war rather than what's good for people.
Right, and the facts.
Yes.
Yes, and the facts behind it.
And we're told it's for our good. The war's for our good. I don't think so. I think it's for a few people who flap their gums more than they should.
Yes.
Instead of actually caring about the welfare and the well-being of the people in this country. Regardless, and I don't care if you're Republican or Democrat, I'm neither. I don't have a political leaning in that respect.
Agreed.
I believe in Jesus Christ, and I believe Jesus is the only answer for life. So we'll put that to rest right there.
Right.
So let's talk and put ourselves in position to
absolutely.
Say, how can we help people?
What's, right, absolutely.
Where are we at, Meg?
Well, there's a lot of information, and I'm sure that... you're being told to go here, and then this is the way to do that. So there's a lot of information floating out. And our recommendation is just to step back, look at your business, see where you're at from a financial standpoint. Do you need the assistance loan? Do you need the paycheck protection? What does your business look like right now? And then make an educated decision that way. We don't recommend just jumping into it
right.
and applying for the loan because you think it's going to go this way, because there's some ramifications and some gray areas in those business loans and paycheck protections that if you don't look for it, you're not going to see.
And, you know, the information about it being forgivable and not forgivable, that's kind of...
There are ramifications with that.
Right,
there
right.
are, and all of those little bullet points have not yet been decided. They haven't come out. So those are going to be changing as we go along and how long this... just the shutdown decides to go on. So, resources.
How do you mean changing? What do you mean by that? What are they saying?
There's every day they update IRS.gov. IRS.gov gets updated about every 30 minutes. So,
oh, wow.
Things that are coming.
30 minutes?
We're talking every 30 minutes. Greg and I check it every 30 minutes because let's just take the stimulus package for example. So if you're a non-filer, that's up there, like there, IRS.gov, you go to the money section, you click on that, and it's going to take you to where you can put direct deposit information and change of address, whatever the case may be for a non-filer. They're updating that to where if you are a filer,
yeah.
and you didn't do direct deposit with your tax return for 2018 and 2019, there's a section on there that you will be able to enter in direct deposit, change of address, but that's not up there yet. So, and they're telling people to check back about every 30 minutes, every hour, because it's updating all the time because there's
wow.
so much information out there and it can be very overwhelming.
Because they're still within the legislation and all the things that are happening that way. They're trying to create... best possible scenario.
They're still fine-tuning it.
I mean,
this was kind of just, we think about when the mandates came down, it hasn't even been a month and a half yet. And they're throwing all this legislation, all this business and all of the stuff to help people stay in business. That's not a lot of time.
No, so, you're trying to do this within months.
Yes,
and that's the thing, folks. Make sure... Go to thetaxoffice.com.
Yes.
Resource Center. Mm-hmm. You can read the CARES Act.
Yes, it's right there.
It's posted.
The link's up there.
The links are up there. Read what's in the CARES Act, because I think it's interesting too, as a small business owner, I've read it, I've looked at it, and I mean, you know, what does this long-term mean for my business? Mm-hmm. Let's go back to work. Let's put the country back to work. Let's put these people back in their place, rather than being dependent upon a government and throwing myself into that with, what is that loan? What's the repayment looking like? What are we doing here?
So I've heard a lot of social bite type thought process. But what Greg and I have seen is, depending on the size of business, the size of your, you know, AGI, your increase over last year versus this year, what your tax return looks like this year, it very well could not be forgivable. They might ask for it back. Now, granted, we're hearing that there will be no interest or penalty added to that, but it won't be a forgiven loan, depending on what type of business you are and what your gross income looks like.
Right.
So that's why we're asking everyone, read that fine print, go on the smallbusinessadministration.gov, look at the application, read that, reach out to your local tax preparer, your accountant, and find out that fine print that you're not really seeing on there. So,
you know, and that's the thing, if you need advice after reading that,
absolutely,
check out call the tax office. Make sure you go and look first, though. Don't just do that. Make sure you read through it. I know we're all a little right now.
I feel like a fish.
Yeah,
like
fish, and it's tough because, you know, a lot of these things we're not used to. Can we afford to even take it to our lawyer and say, what's the best situation?
Right, absolutely, right?
Right. You know, so there's a lot of people dealing with these types of questions, but you know, the information is there. Read it. We're all intelligent people. We
yes.
can read. And we do have the intelligence to work through these things. Talk it out. Don't just do. But I would express, whatever your situation, whatever you're leaning, whatever, get a letter out to your congressman.
Absolutely.
State, mm-hmm. federal, all of it. A letter, a phone call, whatever you would rather do, get out there. Express your...
Let your voice be heard. Let your voice be heard. And visit those resource pages. Research for yourself. Don't just listen to what's going on around you, because it can be very convoluted, both positive and negative. It can be overwhelming in a positive way, like, visit that resource page. We've got three or four links. There is, on the right-hand side of that resource page, you're going to see some bullet points of what you're going to need if you do need that small business loan, because that's what it's there for. If you just, you don't see another way, there is some bullet points of what you might need to fill out that that application. Utilize that resource, and then if you still have questions, please reach out to us, give us a call. And I will tell you, we don't really, at this point, and unfortunately, we don't know any more than what the websites are saying. We have a little bit more with Greg's software and whatnot, that we're getting some updates there. But go to that resource page first. And if you still have questions, please give us a call. We are here. That's what we're here for. Absolutely.
And remember, you know, April 15th, has been pushed back to
July 15th.
Okay.
Both, I'm going to say the majority of states have went right along with the federal. So if you're in a different state and you're seeing this, check with your state government and find out if that, most of them have. I know Missouri went right along with it where we're at. So it's July 15th. And then, if you owe, no penalties, no fines. If you pay that, postmarked by July 15th, you're good to go.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then also after April 15th.
Oh, yes, definitely. after April 15th, I will be in the office. My hours do not change, but Greg will be stepping away for a couple of days to catch his breath after the famous
the rush
tax
of tax
season.
Yeah.
And then he'll be back by appointment only. So, again, he will be there. He's not going anywhere, but he'll be by appointment only.
Yeah, so if you haven't done that, make sure you give the tax office a call.
Absolutely.
If you haven't got your taxes done, you have a reprieve. You have till July 15th, but it'll be appointment only, you know, and it'll set.
And he'll be
motion.
There, absolutely.
Yeah.
And there is there was a question we had the other day. Do you have to file an extension? No, it's an automatic extension.
Okay.
So no paperwork is needed, like if you were to file extension.
Right,
now.
Right.
So
you know, folks, there's a lot going on.
Yes.
agree, disagree with us. Your prerogative. Like I said, it is America. That's up to you. We as micro business owners want to express our thanks to the people around us, absolutely, our loved ones, support us, give us the strength to do this. We care about our community and the people around us. There's a lot of great people in this community. And at these are the times where you see a community, do they pull together? Do they answer that bell? And I think we can. I think we should. And, you know, we need to put aside these differences of, absolutely, politics and take care of our families. That's what America is about. And if we will do that, if we will remember who we are as people and think in those terms, we will make an impact and get ourselves back going in the right direction.
Absolutely.
I believe that very much. Mm-hmm. We hope that this information been good. Remember, thetaxoffice.com/resource center will get you to the links that Megan was talking,
yes,
about. Go there, check it out, read up, read. And make an informed decision, folks, all right? Until the next time, we pray the Lord bless you, keep,
absolutely,
you, strengthen you,
mm-hmm,
and, you know, from
over
the
fear.
Yeah, faith over
faith
fear.
Faith over fear.
Amen. I believe that.
Absolutely.
And until next time, Megan, thank you for joining,
absolutely,
us.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
They're more than the tax office.
We are,
folks,
more than the tax office. Give us a call.